Students, this is JEE class number 16. You look at that question on the board, students. Let A and B be two sets containing four elements and two elements. Set A contains four elements and set B contains two elements respectively. Then the number of subsets of the set A class B. Number of subsets of the set A class B. Each having at least three elements are. That means, here we need to find, here it is asked to find number of all subsets. Each subset should contain at least three. At least three means three or more. Yes, two subsets in the Kandidibeku. Yavatara subsets upandre, subsets only. Minimum, least, at least more element irbeku. At least three andre artha enu. Three or more than three. Let us go for that. So now, number of elements in A. So tell me number of elements in A. Four. So number of elements in B. So two elements. Number of elements in B. Two elements. Now, number of elements in A class B. So, 4 into 2. So, right, 8. Number of subsets. Number of subsets. So, total number of subsets of A class B is 2 power n. So tell me number of elements in A class B. 8. So 2 power 8. So it is 2 2's are 4. 4 4 is 16. 16 16's are 256. So now, first let us find number of subsets having no elements. Number of subsets. So with no elements, that is NC0, so it is total number of elements 8C0, 1, so it is nothing but empty set. Empty set is a subset of every set. Empty set is a subset of every set. Do you know that, students? Next, number of subsets. So number of subsets with one element. That is 8C1, n. Number of subsets with, so two elements, so 8C2, it is 8 into 7 by 2 into 1, 8 into 7 by 2 into 1, so 2 fours are 7 4s are 28. Now, after this, all the subsets should have 3 or more than 3 elements. If I subtract these subsets from that total number of subsets, I am going to get subsets which contain 3 or more elements. One element in the subsets, one element. Two elements in one of the subsets is 8 in the way. Sorry, one element. Two elements in one of the 28. In even bitre, Udi tell us three elements in Reko, the three into just in Reko. Even Allah minus one, the one two subsets are I am going to get required answer. So, right. Number of subsets. Subsets with three R more than three elements. more than three elements is right. So total is 256 minus 1 plus 8 plus 28. So 256 minus 28 plus 8, 36 plus 1, 37. Subtract 256 minus 37. So I think it's 9. 16 minus 7, 9. 4 minus 3, 1. So 2 or 9. So tell me, students.
So number of subsets, total number of subsets with 3 or more than 3 elements should be 290.
I hope which option is correct, students? Option A correct.
Let us go for solving here. One more question. Let us solve one more question, students.
So right. Next question is, a complex number z is called unimodular if mod z is equal to 1. So z1 and z2 are complex numbers, two complex numbers such that z1 minus 2z2 by, so 2 minus z2 bar is unimodular. Unimodular and z2 is not unimodular is not unimodular, then the point z1 like sun. The point z1 lies on. First option A. Straight line. Parallel to x axis. Option B. Straight line. Parallel to y axis. Parallel to y-axis. Option C. Circle of radius 2. So option D. Circle of radius. So root 2. Let us solve this one more question, students.
So look at that.
If modulus of complex number is 1, then that complex number is called as unimodular. Further, it is given this complex number is unimodular. And one more information, z Z2 is not a unimodular, then the point Z1 lies on. Then the point Z1 lies on which curve this point Z1 lies on. So write, let us solve that solution. So write, it is given solution. So Z1 minus 2Z2 by, so 2 minus Z1, Z2 bar is equal to 1. Since it is unimodular, since it is unimodular, so it should be modulus length should be equal to 1. So squaring, this implies, select Z1 minus 2Z2 is equal to, set this right side. So modulus of 2 minus Z1 into Z2 bar. So write, squaring both sides, SPS, square on both sides. So look at the students, Z1 minus 2Z2 whole square is equal to, so 2 minus Z1 into Z2 bar whole square. So you always use this rule. So ZZ bar is equal to mod Z whole square. Z means complex number, Z bar means conjugate complex number. What is the conjugate of X plus IY? It is X minus IY. So write, always use that. So this implies Z1 minus 2Z2 into Z1 bar minus 2Z2 bar is equal to, come to this, so 2 minus, so Z1 Z2 bar into, so 2 minus Z1 bar, so Z2, so right. One thing you remember students, Z bar of bar is Z only. Conjugate of conjugate is complex number only. Conjugate of conjugate is complex number only. So right, you just multiply both sides. You follow this, it's easy. So right, multiply these two first. Z1 bar, Z1 Z1 bar minus, so 2 Z1 Z2 bar minus into plus minus, so 2 Z2 into Z1 bar minus into minus plus 4 Z2 Z2 bar. You come to right side, 2 2s are 4, plus into minus minus, so 2 Z1 bar Z2 minus into plus minus, so 2 Z1, so Z2 bar minus into minus plus Z1 Z1 bar Z1 Z1 bar into Z2 Z2 bar Z2 Z2 bar.
So right students,
so now we will listen. So this is 2 Z1 Z2 Z1 bar. So 2 Z2 Z1 bar get cancelled. Next to 2 Z1 Z2 bar, 2 Z1 Z2 bar get cancelled. So now what I am going to do is Z1 Z1 bar can be written as mod Z1 square. Mod Z1 square. You follow this one. You follow this rule. So right. Next is equal to, so 4 4 Z2 Z2 bar, 4 Z2 Z2 bar, bring that 4 this side, minus, so write 4 minus 4, next minus Z1 bar, Z1 mod whole square, so next mod Z2 whole square is equal to 0. You remove common from these two students, remove common from these two, so write. Now I am going to remove common from this two. Z1 square common, mod Z1 square common, remaining is 1 minus mod Z2 square. So write, next, what is common from these two? 4, minus 4 common. So write, so remaining is minus 4 common. I think this is plus students. Minus 4 common. So if I remove minus 4 as common, so remaining is so mod z2 square, mod z2 z bar, mod z2 square minus becomes plus. I am removing minus, becomes plus. Now minus plus 4, plus 4 common, z2 square minus 1 is equal to 0. So write again, so write, look at this students, 4 common, here it is, I think it's 4, 4, yes correct students, z1 square common, so it's given, so this can be, so given z2 square, and look at this students, so I remove a minus from this, mod z1 square into 1 minus z2 square, remove minus, minus 4 into, so if I remove minus, plus 10 becomes minus, minus 10 becomes plus, 1 minus z2 square is equal to 0. What is common students? So 1 minus z2 square common from both, this factor is common. So now I remove the common. So remove common. So two factors are mod z1 square minus 4 into, so write 1 minus z2 square. I got two factors. So given, so for us it is given, given, so z2 is not unimodular. Z2 is not unimodular. Z2 value never becomes 1. If z2 is not equal to 1, this quantity is not equal to 0. So that implies 1 minus z2 square is not equal to 0. If z2 does not become 1, the value of this quantity is not equal to 0. If this factor is not equal to 0, this must be 0. Because product has already become 0. Product has already become 0. So that implies, so z1 square minus 4 is equal to 0. So that implies z1 square is equal to 4. So that means a complex number. I'll take the complex number as x plus iy whole square is equal to 4. X plus iy whole square is equal to 4. So length of a complex number, root of x plus iy, so whole square is equal to 4. So that means square will get cancelled. So root of x square plus y square, length of the complex number, root of x square plus y square, square root get cancels. This implies x square plus y square is equal to 4. Okay, students, we got a circle. The point z1 lies on a circle with radius 2. Which option is correct? Option C correct. Let us solve one more question, students. One more simple question. So next question is let look at this one more question students, alpha and beta be the roots of the equation x square minus 6x minus 2 0. If a n is equal to alpha power n minus beta power n, then the value of this quantity, options are given 6 minus 6, 3 minus 3. Let us go for solving this question, so it's so easy question. So I take solution alpha 10 minus 2 into alpha 8 by, so 2 alpha 9, so alpha 10 or an, so write, sorry students, this is a 10, a 8, a 9, a 10, a 9, 8, a 9, so write a 10, a 8, a 9, so tell me a 10, according to this, a 10, alpha power 10 minus beta power 10, So put n is equal to 10. Put n is equal to 10. Minus, so 2 into a8. You find this a8 from this. a8. Alpha power 8. So minus beta power 8. Old 8 by 2 times a9. Alpha power 9. So alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. Multiply by minus alpha power 10 minus beta power 10 minus, so 2 alpha 8, so 2 alpha 8, alpha power 8 minus into minus plus, so 2 beta power 8, so all divided by, so 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9.
So you look at the students,
we have a common. What is common from these two? Alpha power 8. Again, what is common from these two? Beta power 8. So it is alpha power 8 common. So remaining is, so alpha square minus 2. Again, what is common from these two students? Minus, so beta power 8. So tell me that minus has been removed. So this becomes plus beta square minus 2. So by so 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So look at this, students. Here it is given. In the question it is given. Alpha and beta are the roots. Since alpha is a root of this equation, it must satisfy. Root means 0. So alpha is the root of this equation, it must satisfy. So that implies alpha is root of x square minus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0. So that implies alpha square minus 6 alpha minus 2 should be 0. So this implies, so at segment 6 alpha right side, alpha square minus 2 is equal to 6 alpha. Again, beta is also root. Beta is also root. Root. That implies beta square minus 2 is equal to 6 beta. You substitute both in this. Substitute both in this. So alpha power 8 into, how much is alpha square minus 2? So we have 6 alpha minus beta power 8. Beta power 8 into, so beta power 8 into, so how much is beta square minus 2? 6 beta. So by, so 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So last step, students. So last step. So look at this. Last step. So write. So that is alpha power 6 into alpha power 9 minus 6 into beta power 9. So by 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. What is common? 6. So alpha power 9 minus beta power 9 by, so 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. These two get cancelled, students. 2, 3 is them. So tell me answer 3. Which of them is correct? Option C correct. So let us stop this class. We shall continue in the next class. Thank you.